Hey, it's Kaylee. In this video, we're going to play a game about solving for equivalent fractions, and then you get to play it on your own. All right, so I'm in the home screen of the fractions equality game, and we're going to start with the lab just to get things going. So I'm going to click on that. And now I'm in the lab here, and you'll see I have a set of four shapes here and then another set here, and they're gonna have different amount of spaces available, and we're gonna show how to make them equivalent or the same, and we'll be able to see the numerical values down here and how those are equivalent. All right, so right now it looks like these four on the left side have a denominator of 1, and these on the right side have a denominator of 2. And we'll see that there's two spaces on the right side, and where the denominator is 1, just one space. And we're going to try to figure out if I have 0 out of 1 and 0 out of 2, if I add colors to this, how do I make them equal? All right. So if I wanted to make a whole, so I wanted to have 1 out of 1, how is that going to be equal to the halves over here? So if I add 1 here, that means that there's 2 out of 2. So remember, everything is a whole if the numerator and the denominator match. So here we have 1 and 1, and over on the half side, we have 2 and 2. So now we can say 2 halves is equal to 1 whole. Nice. So let's put that back. Now let's make the left side, my first side over here, have a denominator of 2. So now we're going to explore how a half, a 2 on the bottom, can be equal to a quarter fraction. Okay? So let's think about this. If I wanted to fill in 1 out of my 2, so I wanted to have a half, how many spaces out of my quarters, out of my fourths, will need to be filled in to be the same? An easy way to think about this is to think about the area of the circle that will have color. So if I fill in 1 of my halves over here, I'm going to have to fill in the same amount of color on these ones here. So it'll be 2 of my fourths will be colored in to be equal to 1 half. So let's see how that happens. If I put 1 in there, I see 2 got filled in there. Nice. Now what would happen if I made this 2 out of 2? If I made it a whole, what would happen to this circle here? Right, the numerator and the denominator always have to match. So if this one's going to be 2 out of 2, then that would make this one 4 out of 4. So let's see that happen. I'm putting that there. 2 out of 2, 4 out of 4. So now we see whenever we have 1 half, we get 2 fourths. So let's see if I put that back. Remember, 1 half is equal to 1 2 fourths. Nice. So let's put those away. Now let's see what happens when we have a third. So I'm going to change this guy to 3. And that is going to make these guys 6. So I have 1, 2, 3 spaces over here. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces available over here. So I just want you to make a hypothesis. If we put 1 third over here, so if we fill in 1 of the spaces out of 3, how many of the spaces out of 6 will need to be filled in to make them equivalent? What do you think? Remember, you can think about colored in area. So if one of these is colored in, how many of these slices is going to be the same amount? Let's see if you're right. I'm going to put one slice in there. Boop. It fills in 2 6. So you can think about that. 1/3 is equal to 2 6. So knowing that, what do you think will happen if we have 2/3? How many of the 6 spaces will be filled in? If I have 2/3 over here, how many more of these are going to be filled in? If I put that there, boop, 2 more. So 2/3 is equal to 4/6. So for every 1/3, we get 2/6. And now, again, I'm going to try to make this a whole. So I'm going to make 3 out of 3. What will that make this? Right, 6 out of 6. So put that in there. So 3 out of 3 is equal to 6 out of 6. And that just means everything is colored in and we have a whole. Nice job. So I'm back in the home screen now for the fractions equality simulation. And this time we get to play the game. So I'll click here. And it's asking me to choose the level I want to play. And for this demo, let's play level 2 together. So I'm clicking on level 2. It takes me in here. So now you'll see that I have a scale over here and a scale over here and all of these pictures down here. What I'm trying to do is make matches between this scale and this scale out of these cards. And then I'll check my answer and it will tell me if I'm right or wrong. Okay. So let's start. Let's just start with the first one here. I'll put this guy here. So looking at this picture, what do you see? I see 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 spaces are possible. And I see 1, 2 are colored in. So I have a 4 on the bottom and I have a 2 on the top. So what other shapes in here would have 4 total spaces, or a 4 on the bottom and 2 on the top? So I see this one has a 4 on the bottom. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces, but it has a 3 on the top. So that means 3 would be colored in. So that's not right. Let's see. It looks like these triangles have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 triangles, but this one has 3 colored in. We need only 1, 2 colored in. What about this triangle? It says 1, 2, 3, 4 total spaces and 1, 2 are colored in. So that seems like it could be our match. Put that there and let's check. We're good. So we can say okay. And now our matches are there. All right, let's try another one. Let's see. Let's do 2/3. So I have 2 on the top, so that means there's 2 spaces colored in, but I have 3 on the bottom. So that means out of 3 total spaces, only 2 are colored in. So let's see, this one has 3 spaces, but it only has 1 colored in. This one only has 2 spaces. This one also has 3 spaces, but only 1 colored in. And this one, 1, 2, 3 spaces and 2 are colored in. So that would be 2 out of 3. Put that there. Let's check. We're right. Okay. All right. Let's keep it going. I'm going to put this one in here now. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4 total triangles. So 4 shapes. And I have 1, 2, 3 colored in. So if I have 4 total, that means there's a 4 on the bottom. And if I have 3 colored in, I have a 3 in my numerator or on top. So let's see. This one here has a 4 on the bottom. That's how many shapes we have in total. And a 3 on the top, which is how many are colored in. So perfect. Our first try is right. Put that there. We'll give it a check. Goes to 3/4. Perfect. Alrighty, let's try another one. Let's put this one here. So it looks like I have 1, 2 kind of funny looking shapes, but I only have 1 that's colored in. So let's see. This one only has 1 colored in, but it has 1, 2, 3 total spots. What about this one's also green and white, but that looks like a lot more than only 2. So what about this one? There's 2 spaces available and 1's colored in. So it kind of looks the same. Put that there. Let's check it. And we're right. All right. Let's try this fraction, the number now. So 3 on the top, 6 total spaces, and 3 are colored in. So out of our remaining cards, which one has 3 colored in? Looks like this one has 1, 2, 3 colored in, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 total spaces. Perfect. Put that there, and we'll check. Perfect. And our last one, by default, looks like 1, 2, 3 total spaces. So a 3 would be on the bottom. We have 1 colored in, so that would be 1/3. This one looks the same. Check it. All right. We did it. So nice job. Now you get to play this game on your own. You can start with the Equality Lab here to just get you warmed up with how to make fractions look the same when you have different number of spaces available. And then you can go ahead and play the game. So have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.